Yes, hello students. We are going to start the next lecture. That is recombination process. The recombination process is applied for the production of most dairy products, and it has helped in creating new foods and formulations. See, this recombination process and the production of dairy products is most important for their dairy science. The recombination is the process of recombining milk fat and milk solids, not fat, that is SNF, in one or more of either their various forms with or without water. So this recombination process is recombining milk fat, that is a solid, not fat. See, in the buffalo milks, there is a solid fat, and the cow's milk, there is a non-solid fat. This recombination must be made so as to re-establish the products, specified fat to solid not fat ratio and solid to water ratio. The recombined process was first used widely during World War II and then onward spread the worldwide. So at the time of this worldwide, this recombination process in the dairy products, they are utilized in the first times. So as you know very well, this the composition of milk is essentially for their peoples, and the main advantages of this recombination of the milk is it gives better opportunities for transfer of raw material from a surplus area via industry and manufacturing to fulfill demand in deficiency areas for the local range of milk and the milk byproducts. So there is a various type of the milk byproducts, the ice cream, cheese, butter, you know very well the as a paneer, they are made from the milk products and the milk byproducts. And the supplements and support local milk and other products such as vegetables and oils and sugars, similarly with the milk byproduct. And it generates the possible employment for local populations at dairy as well as with related activities, and it creates goodwill and interest with the authorities. See, this RSCM and skim milk powder to the water, stir at 50 degree centigrade approximately the 20 minutes, and add the melted fat and other dry ingredients. They are the one by one, the ascending orders they are given. The deaerated, the preheat at to 60 degree centigrade. Similarly, in pasteurization methods, homogenization 40 kb per centimeter square, pasteurization 90 degree at 60 to 90 for 1 minute, the flash cool to 30 degree and sealed with the lactose, and the crystallization and the filling is the process for their animals. See, this procedure, add skim milk powder to the water while stirring at approximate 50 degree centigrade, and stir for approximate only the 20 minutes and melt the fat. Again, add the melted fat, pulse guard, dairy emulsifier, pulse guard and other dry ingredients to the water phase while stirring the deaerated. So this preheat 60 degree centigrade, homogenization 40 kp per centimeter square, pasteurization, crystallization, filling is method which are important for the byproduct. See, the mixing together of the processing, dispersion is effort effected using high speed blade, a powder funnel and centrifugal pump, a powder liquid blender or number of other devices designed for the purpose. The care should be taken to minimize air incorporation, or a deaerator can be used. The liquid fat 55 to 60 degree centigrade may be added before after or power the powder minimize, and the ratio of this homogenization is required, otherwise the fat separation result. म्हणजे तुम्हाला जर मिल्कमधून फॅट सेपरेशन करायचं असेल तर अशा प्रकारे प्रोसेस करणं हे अत्यंत आवश्यक आहे. आणि म्हणून ती 40-50 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड टेम्परेचरला आपल्याला मिल्क हीट करावं लागेल. आफ्टर हायड्रेशन टाइम ऑफ अबाउट 15 मिनिट्स ड्युरिंग विच द डिस्पर्स पावडर कम्प्लीट डिझोल्युशन, द शुगर कॅन बी ॲडेड अँड डिझॉल एजिटेशन स्टॉप टू मिनिमाइज air incorporation and to save power. During sugar addition, mix is heated to maintain temperature 40 to 50 degree centigrade temperature and melted fat 50 degree centigrade. When the full cream powder is used, highest possible level of the transfer of the heat used mixing the stage achievement the maximum. So the filtration, how is filtration of the milk is carried out in duplex type filters using a range of filters from milk prior to the homogenization. The preheating to homogenization temperature 50 to 60 degree centigrade is done. The higher temperature adversely affects heat stability of combined evaporated milk. Homogenization is from several system high pressure unit using shear type valve is commonly used for recombined preparation. Usual pressures and range is 140 to 175 kilogram per centimeter square for first stage and 35 kilogram centimeter square on second stage. So this increasing the pressure of first stage may reduce heat stability of protein prior to homogenization recombinant and is applied at the end. Pasteurization and cooling methods. The recombinant may be heated to homogenization temperature or pasteurized to extend its storage life and cooled greater than 5 degree centigrade. And the pasteurization condition is used ranges about 80 to 90 for 30 seconds to 2 minutes. And only 60 degrees centigrade, it will take only 30 minutes. So, this methods is used for the recombinant milks of their process. So, you can see this lactose seeding methods, how it lactose there looks crystallization from the milk. म्हणजे मिल्कमध्ये मिल्क लॅक्टोज कशाप्रकारे असते ते, त्याच्यानंतर कॅनिंग अँड स्टरलायझेशन आपण करतो. तुम्हाला माहीत आहे कॅनिंग कसं करायचं, मिल्कला सॉलिड फॅट काढून त्याच्यामधून चांगल्या प्रकारे मोल्ड करायचं, स्टरलाइज करायचं, त्याच्यामधून आपण कॅनिंग करता येते आणि स्टरलाइज करता येते. हे दिलेलं आहे रिकॉम्बिनंट स्वीटन्ड कंडेन्स्ड मिल्क, फॅट सॉलिड नॉट फॅट आणि टोटल फॅट कशाप्रकारे दिलेलं आहे ते.